My name is Dan Rosanova, and I'm joined today by Addison Huddy. Hi, Addison.
Hey, Dan.
How you doing?
I'm pretty good. I'm excited to talk about this. This will be good.
It'll be fun. We're here today to talk about how Confluent completes the event streaming platform with Confluent Platform 6 and Project Metamorphosis. But before we dive too deep into this, I do need to go through a disclaimer. As our roadmap may change in the future, the features referred to herein may change, may not be delivered on time, or may not be delivered at all. This information is not a commitment to deliver any functionality. Customers should make their purchasing decisions based on features that are currently available. And with that out of the way, we can state what our goal is here at Confluent, which is to build a complete event streaming platform based on Apache Kafka and help you turn it into the central nervous system for all of your events across data stores, logs, third-party apps, custom apps and microservices to enable contextual event-driven applications like real-time inventory, real-time data transformation, real-time customer 360, and real-time fraud detection. And to do this both on the cloud and on-prem.
So let me talk a little bit about what Project Metamorphosis is and how it relates to Confluent Cloud and Confluent Platform 6.0. So Metamorphosis, it's named after Franz Kafka's best known work. And it really, it means transformation. And that's what Confluent Platform and Kafka are going through right now. A transformation to be more cloud native. And we've been putting a structure around how to communicate these themes of cloud native as they relate to Kafka by every month having a theme. So we started out with Elastic and cost-effective, been talking about infinite, and we're about to talk about global. And today, Dan and I are going to run you through three of these and the features that kind of come out of these themes.
And Elastic was a great theme to start with for us, because at its base, Elastic is probably the first hard challenge for Kafka. Kafka itself just isn't very elastic. It's extremely scalable, but its design was really more built around a stable infrastructure. Scaling it up and down can be hard. Moving partitions around can be difficult. Rebalancing can take a long amount of time. And this is where we started off Metamorphosis, is in how we make these more simple, especially in our cloud, which is where we started this. When you look at what you have to do to scale Kafka in a cloud environment, on some cloud services, you would really need to think about all of these steps on the left, which are that you're going to determine how much capacity you actually need to scale up to. You have to procure that capacity, configure brokers, and then you actually have to do the Kafka work of identifying which partitions on which brokers are going to move over to the new brokers and replan along the way. In Confluent Cloud, we've made this really simple. On our basic and standard tiers, which are designed for workloads less than 100 megabytes per second, you simply do nothing. Send more data, and the service scales automatically for you. And it scales back down when you're done sending the data. So there's nothing to do on your side. It happens instantly. On our dedicated tier, which is designed for larger throughput workloads, things in the gigabyte per second range, you just go into the management UI, click the dropdown for units for CKUs, and decide how many you want, and click apply changes. And the changes start rolling out within minutes. All of these same things are still happening, but they're fully managed within our service. So they're completely automatic for you. We've actually gone even further and brought these same seamless scale capabilities to Confluent Platform.
So in Confluent Platform and in Confluent Platform 6.0, we're bringing a feature that was developed in our cloud first, and then we're bringing it into Confluent Platform. And we call this feature self-balancing clusters. So all the partitions, moving them around, calculating plans, you no longer have to worry about that. Confluent Platform is self-balancing. If you add a broker, the system recognizes that, it scales up. If you remove a broker, the system recognizes that, and it scales down. If there's a partition that is hot, it recognizes that and calculates a more optimal configuration and moves the partitions around. And unlike other systems where you have to be watching them, managing them, this is all built directly into Confluent Platform. It's constantly looking at the cluster, calculating plans, and rebalancing itself. You go in Confluent Control Center, you turn on self-balancing, the system does everything else. It's really set it and forget it. But managing partitions and rebalancing, that's only a part of being cloud native. How storage is handled in the cloud is different too. And Confluent Platform now can take advantage of this. Historically, the way that you scaled up storage in Kafka is you scale up brokers. You need more storage, you add more disks to the brokers, you get more brokers, and it just scales. But this is difficult, it's not very cost effective, and now there's a better way.
And that better way we've already brought to our cloud. Infinite retention in Confluent Cloud is really about the next step of scale. In our cloud platform, we used to have storage limits, and we no longer do. Instead of having to think about how much storage you're going to need within a cluster, within a tier of our product, you simply pay for the data that you send and store Confluent Cloud. Flat rate pricing per gigabyte. And it scales infinitely, which is why we use that theme. We've actually tested this up to 1 petabyte clusters, which there's a demo that's been recorded by Tim that you'll probably be able to see. And it's something that, again, we've done in our cloud, and we've also brought to Confluent Platform to complete this story even more. These same infinite storage features we've also brought to Confluent Platform with tiered storage. Tiered storage lets you offload old events to cheaper third-party object storage to reduce costs. It uses the object store of a cloud provider that you choose and enables infinite data retention in Kafka. And when you combine this with self-balancing clusters, Confluent Platform is really giving you the elasticity and scalability that you would normally get from a cloud-native platform on-prem or in whatever environment you choose to run it in. You get a very elastic experience that you can run anywhere, which actually brings us to our last theme of global access. When we look at global, Kafka is a distributed system by nature, but it's still distributed within one region or one data center. Global is a whole new set of challenges about how do you take this capability and extend it around the globe, around just beyond one data center to multiple data centers. Kafka actually has a few of its most important core attributes which make this challenging. One is offsets. Having a stable log means that you get repeatable read, and that's part of the power of Kafka. But it also requires you to have offsets that are stable between all of the replicas or when you replicate the data between clusters. Other components that you might need to run to do this also have complications that come with them in a global environment. Running things like Zookeeper, running things like Replicator or Mirror Maker or Connect. You know, all these things together aren't really cloud native technologies as they were first created. And that's the last theme we want to talk about today and something we've been working hard to make more simple. Addison?
2 years ago, Confluent embarked upon a project that we call Global Kafka. It's a multi-year project that would introduce more features into Confluent that, well, would make Confluent Platform more global. And the first feature that we released is multi-region clusters, which makes a viable stretch cluster architecture that provides the best HA and disaster recovery solution for Kafka. But we know there are times when a single cluster isn't going to do it. So whether that's cross-continent topic sharing, breaking down silos between organizations, hybrid or multi-cloud use cases, cloud migration, or even integrating with different partners. Connect-based solutions have all the limitations that Dan mentioned earlier. So this is why we're introducing a new feature that we call cluster linking. Cluster linking is byte-for-byte replication from one cluster to another. It's offset preserving, it's less infrastructure to run, it's a broker in one cluster talking with a broker in another cluster. We're excited that this feature is going to be coming to Confluent Cloud first and then Confluent Platform. And it unlocks a global eventing platform when you combine it with multi-region clusters combined with cluster linking. It creates a global mesh of Kafka, where Kafka can be the center of all the data running in your ecosystem. This is going to be great for hybrid cloud, multi-cloud, cloud migration, And eventually we'll support more and more use cases. But we're really excited about this feature, and we're excited as it debuts in Confluent Cloud.
That sounds pretty exciting, Addison. I'm looking forward to it. We've seen today how Confluent is pushing Project Metamorphosis, both in our cloud and in Confluent Platform, to drive elastic in terms of throughput, infinite through storage, and global with cluster linking, and how these new cloud-native architecture of Kafka is going to enable a whole set of workloads that have been out of our reach so far. If you're interested in learning more about Kafka, please visit developer.confluent.io and start building with Apache Kafka. Thank you for joining us. And Addison, thank you for being with me today.
Thank you, Dan. And if you want to reach either Dan or I, these are our emails. These are our Twitter usernames. I know both of us are always on the community Slack. We're looking forward to your questions, to your feedback, and thank you for your time.